It may be a day later than usual, but the pinnacle of the school's rugby calendar is here. It's the Leinster Schools Senior Cup Final. Quangos versus St Michael's, and it's live from the RDS. Kick off in about half an hour. G'day, great to have your company on a fantastic weekend for schoolboy rugby. It's a lot of fun, a lot of excitement, and as always, great rugby. Joining me as always is Neil Francis. Franno, you played in three of these. It's a great day for the schools, for the parents, but it's something the boys never forget.
Yeah, I think certainly 15 or whatever they are, is it 22? They have squads of 22.
Yeah.
The you know, for 22 of them, their lives will change. So one squad will enjoy, you know, a fantastic day and something that'll last until they're 60, 70, 80. And the other guys will live to regret it. It's just unfortunate, and it's the thing about Cup Rugby, you know, and they've only one chance at it. Two best teams in the competition. I mean, they were fated to meet each other, and they were very lucky. They barely made it. Clongowes made very tough weather out of beating Terenure, and St Michael's drew 16-all with Ross Cray, who were the finalists last year. They were probably just looking so far ahead to the final that you actually trip up with the, you know, the smaller players. But absolute. I mean, I've seen both of these teams play, and the quality in these teams is just phenomenal. I watched Michael's play a friendly against Blackrock, and one of the guys I was there with observed, you know, he said, well, when you were playing back in 80, 81, a long time ago, he said, you were phenomenal, you were exceptional in terms of your physique. He said, if you were playing out there today, nobody would even notice you.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they are huge packs on both sides, particularly the Michael's pack. It's just phenomenal size.
There's live pitches. Neil, it's absolutely beautiful weather, a great day for rugby. And these two teams have forged a path to get there that has been really entertaining, a great journey for the boys. So let's take you and home through that journey to the final.
Defenders to come in, great release, the gap opens up, another try for Clongowes, Stephen Keelan the one to get in beside the post. Wallace controlling at the back, good work. Sam Condon got up quickly, Clongowes there moved the ball wide, can they create an opening here? Good handling once again, it's very tight, dive for the line, second attempt, the ball is touched down, is the try awarded? It is indeed. Once again, this time they keep it among the speed merchants. Thrown out to Fagan, surely to try. Chris Fagan gets in and scores. It's a difficult one to take. Ross Maloney did well. Lawless at the back of the ball, holding on. Here goes the break from Lawless. Touchdown, try. McQuaid looks like he's shaping for the box kick. Gets good height on it, hanging up in the breeze a little bit. Taken by Billy Dardis, fired all the way wide. Can this be scooped up? Chance here. Sam O'Brien racing for the corner, looking out for pace. He knows he's in. Try for Tanya in the corner. Ball is there for McQuaid. Steps back from the threat of Terenure, got it to Nicholson. It was tackled. It's turnover ball for Terenure. Can they set up a try? Chance here. Brewer kept the ball well. Jarvis into the line. Steps away from one tackle. Jarvis with the corner. Touchdown! What a finish by Terenure. Terenure, confidence will grow. The greater the pressure to be on Clongas. There's the chance. McQuaid, what a try! They tried that move before in the Senior Cup. It's worked this time. McQuaid is through the line out. And a brilliant response from Clongas. Little 1-2 back to Sullivan. Nicholson throws the ball all the way wide. Is there a chance of an overlap here for Clongas? They get the ball out wide. It's a race for the line. Keno Donohue, is he going to score? Did he get the ball? Touchdown in the dirt, says he did. Weakley has a look. Terenure come to the left-hand side. Once again, it's intercept. Knock on. Did Terenure get another chance? They don't. Aino Dad blows the full-time whistle. An unbelievable match at Donnybrook. Terenure 10, Clongas Wood 13. Gets the ball out to Ross Byrne. Byrne takes it a second time, pops it up nicely. O'Loughlin into a bit of space, skips away from one tackle. Great handoff from O'Loughlin. O'Loughlin's going to score under the post. Wonderful try by St. Michael's. Well, there seemed to be a break in that defence coming. Sends it on its way. He's got that absolutely perfect. He's nailed that one. What a kick. St. Michael's advance to the final.
Well, these are live shots from the RDS as the teams warm up, and there's some fabulous rugby in there. I love schoolboy rugby. It's so pure, always exciting. The boys haven't become cynical enough to know how to cheat at the breakdown and slow things down. It's always spectacular. Franno, we've probably seen a shift in the last few years from your old school, from Blackrock College that dominated for so long. That's Bernard Jackman with the hat on there running the defence drills. From Blackrock College to seeing St Michael's and Clongas really being the dominant teams of the competition over the last few years.
Yeah, over the last 5 years they have. They've stepped to the mark. It's all about how seriously you want to take it. So they have been resourced. And the demands that are put on these kids, I don't think I would ever have made it out of the SAT for the...
You'd get expelled.
Well, but they're doing weights before, you know, they're doing weights at 7 o'clock, they're working at lunchtime, they're working after lunch, they're scrummaging at night, you know, special diets, everything. I mean, they are professional players. Mm. And one of the things that, I mean, the Leinster branch, there has been a schism between some of the schools and the Leinster branch, because it is felt now that the Leinster branch have come in and have tried to take over control of the players in these colleges. And I wouldn't blame them, because the quality that's coming through. I mean, Leinster want to control, you know, their conveyor belt, and this is how they do it. You know, but you'll see it now, 2012, that you'll see eight or nine of these two teams coming in, and they'll be in contention for the Leinster Academy and Leinster in the next two or three years.
Well, it's certainly produced some great players over the years, because Robbie Carney played in this game only a few years ago. And we will be back after this break with the kickoff, only moments away. Stay with us. Welcome back as we count down to the kickoff of the Leinster Schools Senior Cup. Great game coming up. Let's hear from last year's winning coach and the current coach of Clongas College, Noel McNamara.
Noel McNamara, head coach of Clongas Wood. How are the nerves of a few and all the guys?
Oh, listen, you know, there's bound to be nerves, but, you know, it's a great place to be all the same. You know, it's a cup final, day after Patrick's Day, albeit, but, you know, it's fantastic to be here. Beautiful day. We're really looking forward to it now, to be honest.
Yeah, it's a smashing day for rugby. The pitch is in great condition. Everybody's fitting well?
Yeah, listen, you know, we have a full deck to play with. The pitch is fantastic, you know, it's all systems go. Looking forward to it now.
And a little bit of experience from last year, do you think that'll help your team?
Oh, listen, you know, a couple of them have been here before, but it's cup final, all bets are off. You know, it's going to be a real test, and hopefully we'll come out the other side of it.
Well, no, thanks very much, and best of luck to you.
Thanks very much. Thank you.
Well, they certainly played a great final last year, but Coach McNamara's right, last year's over. It's about this year. But they've got a few good players this year as well, Frano, especially up front. The twins there, leading out the Byrne boys, Ed and Brian. Ed's the loose head, Brian's the hooker. Just see him at loose head here in the purple and white stripes there at Clongowes. Good players, mate.
Well, just talking about the Leinster branch, I think both of them are signed up already.
Into the academy.
And I think that's they're geared, that's all they want to do, I think. Apparently that's what I'm led to believe. So, and after yesterday's performance, we can't grow up quickly enough. The thing about these guys is that they are very intelligent. You can see it, they're footballers. I'd say they could do anything if you gave them a shot at out half. They'd be able to do that as well. They're footballers.
Don't encourage props to do that. No,
but well, I mean, lovely, just yeah, lovely
yeah.
hands.
Yeah, great hands.
They have everything, yep. And that's what this team can do. They've played a brand of rugby. Nobody really wanted to tackle them there. Mm. They're just playing a brand of rugby, which is, as you have said, it's not as cynical as the you know, and it's with real invention. You know, and they play, you know, an offload game. They play a very expansive game. They play clever cup winning rugby. Mm. And
you can see them here just practicing their skills and lovely technique there. Look at his hands finishing where the ball is. That's fantastic. Yeah. Great technique, and that's what you really need with line out throwing. We don't see enough of that, and that's it's very impressive. But their footwork's been impressive too, for big guys. When we've been watching the tapes of them, you can see it there in the try. They're sidestepping, they're transferring the ball, they're looking to offload. And as you say, the attitude of all the players, but especially these two young blokes, is really positive. They want to play attacking rugby.
Well, they nearly got it wrong against Terenure. You know, they went for scrums the whole time. They were so confident of their ability there that their confidence almost was the undoing of them. But they got it. They got over the finish line just about against a smart enough Terenure side, who also had enough quality players. I mean, they've about four or five guys there that will also make a they'll make a dent later on in at underage level, and maybe even later on. I think Brewer, you know, is a very good player. So.
Very good young player. Don't know if he's a 13. Might like to see him in the back row like his dad. Mm. But I agree with you with that. Let's get across to the opposition now. St Michael's, who were also last year's finalists and didn't come up with the money last year. Let's talk to their coach, Kevin Leahy, and see what the chances for Michael's are this year.
Kelvin Lee, head coach of St Michael's. A lot of effort has gone in to get to the side this far. How are you feeling?
We're feeling very well. It's been a long season, but it's just magnificent to be at this stage to get to the final. And what a fantastic stage it is in the RDS.
Yeah, perfect conditions here. We'll hope for a great match.
Yeah, looking forward to the game. The wind may be a little bit blowy, but it's certainly dry underfoot, and we couldn't ask for a better pitch.
Well, you've had a chance to look at Clongowes Wood over the season. How do you prepare for this? Defend against them, your own plan, a bit of both?
When you get to finals of competitions, it's all about playing the match and not the occasion. So it's just focusing on what we do well and making sure that, if you can, do the ordinary things extraordinarily well.
And the guys are walking around, they're looking all very fit and relaxed. How do you keep their nerves under control?
Oh, these group are as cool a group as you could ever meet. They've been a pleasure to work with, and they themselves are just looking forward to the game and playing what comes up against them.
Calvin, a pleasure to talk to you again. Thank you very much indeed.
Thanks, John. Thank you.
Some great words of wisdom there from Coach Lee. Very, very smart stuff. Michaels have got some good players of their own, Frano. They've got this young man running around, Dan Leahy at 7, who is a very good ball carrier. What's the sidestepping and the offloading on him in this sequence here? Neil?
This, but that type of game they're playing, that's the professional game as it should be played. I mean, Michaels, I think, are the only team that can actually possibly take on this Clongowes side. I think Clongowes just about beat them in the friendly.
Yeah, he's athletic, Levy, isn't he? Looking at the really athletic tackle and forced the turnover with it. Watch his footwork here too, Neil. Really lovely footwork.
The beach beat him, I think.
Donnybrook Stream got the bit of Robbie Mair. Look at the sand coming. I mean, very strong in the tackle. Good steal, like a good open side should. And Ross Byrne, he's kicked 9 out of 9 in the quarter and semi. Lovely technique. Look at this one, Frank.
Yeah, no run up, just two, three steps and pretty accurate.
Yeah, 9 from 9. Can't ask more than that in a quarter and a semi.
It's interesting about the coaching thing. If you look at the Ireland coaches over the last couple of years, like, you know, you've had Eddie O'Sullivan, who's been a teacher. You've had Declan Kidney, who's been a teacher. Brian McLaughlin's been a teacher. Mm. And there's an awful lot of quality coaches who haven't been put into the Rabo, Magners, grinding machine. And you'd wonder now what the next step for those guys is, because I don't know who Noel McNamara is, but he's done a very good job at Clongowes, and Kelvin has done a brilliant job as well in Michaels. So if they ever get tired, bring him up.
You will, and the only thing is you can stay at schools for 20 years and keep winning. Yeah. unless you end up on TV, you get kicked out. Anyway, we're having a bit of fun there. It is great rugby. It is the purest example of the way the game's played, and it's coming up very soon. Stay with us. Kickoff, not far away. Welcome back. There's pictures from the RDS. The boys from Clongowes there in the stands. And it is deafening when you're out there. Neil and I were out there last year on the sidelines. We couldn't hear ourselves think. We couldn't hear what our directors were saying. Kids just have an absolute ball. And it's bathed in sunshine. A lovely day. There's the boys from St Michael's. Won't be long before we get across to kickoff there now. And we're going to move across to our commentators out there, John Forrest and Peter McKenna, and I'll be very interested in what Peter has to say about young Diamond, the fullback for St Michael's. Pete being a great fullback himself. Let's get across and hear their thoughts and get all the feeling on the atmosphere and the action out of the RDS with John and Peter.
A very good afternoon and welcome to the RDS for the Powerade Leinster Schools Cup Final 2012. It's a beautiful afternoon, perfect conditions for open rugby. Clongowes Wood are aiming for a 3 in a row up against St Michael's, who Clongowes beat in the semi last year and in the final in 2010. So St Michael's with some scores to settle. Clongowes Wood make a few changes in the back line. Max McFarland returns to fullback. Keane Donoghue starts on the left wing with Conor Mahoney continuing on the right. Sebastian Frome also returns. He will partner Garvin McVerry in the centre. Mark Nicholson and Conor McQuaid are the halfbacks once again. The Clongowes pack is unchanged. Father Timmins, Stephen Keelan and John Wallace are a lively back row. Jack Paul and Robert Daly are the second row pairing. Daniel O'Byrne, Brian Byrne and the captain, Edward Byrne, are the Clongowes front row. St Michael's came through a tough battle against Kilkenny and make a single change for today's final. The pack is unchanged. Andy Barr, Gavin Kelly and Jamie Lawless are the powerful front row. Ross Maloney and Andy Coleman are in the engine room. Dan Levy, captain St Michael's at 7. Josh Murphy and Donna Lawler complete the back row. At halfback, Bobby Holland partners Ross Byrne. The one change for St Michael's comes on the wing where Cian Kelleher starts. Chris Fagan and fullback Cameron Diamond are the threats from deep. The two Rorys, Kavanagh and O'Loughlin, are the centre pairing again today. Both sides have made good use of the benches in the cup so far. And all these players will be really, really keen to get on and see some action today. With me is Peter McKenna. Peter, great atmosphere here at the RDS for this.
It's really starting to rev up here. Crowd getting right behind both respective teams. As we watch the Clongowes boys here right in front of the stand where all the Clongowes supporters are, they've looked steely and determined in the build-up to this game. And it's wonderful playing conditions here today. It's a strong breeze going left to right as you look out on the pitch. Two teams are like playing with the ball in hand, and I think we're in store for a real rugby treat this afternoon.
Well, St Michael's are making Clongowes wait. Is that mind games, do you think?
I think so. They're in no rush. They hope, I suppose, the occasion might get the Clongowes. Clongowes looking to play for 3 in a row here. They're hoping they're feeling the nerves, and Michael's looking to play on that.
St. Michael's side get a huge cheer from the fans, led out by their captain, Dan Levy. And we'll be ready to join us after the break. Of the Leinster branch, Kevin Beggs is the TMO. New adventure for the players here, Peter, having a TMO, I think you'll be called on.
Well, it's just reflects how professional the game is getting, even at this lower stage of their careers at schools level. Both sides really have been professionally trained in the attitude displayed by both schools, the best of coaches, the best of facilities, the amount of time and effort that has gone into these players, and I suppose it's only fairly reflected in having something like the TMO available for the final for what is a magnificent occasion.
St. Michael's will kick off. Sky blue shirts playing from right to left. Clongos ready to receive the ball. The 2012 Powerade Leinster Senior Cup final is underway. Great height in the kickoff. Good chase. Michael's come up with possession. Well, that's the sort of start they needed. Taran Ure showed against Clongos that they are not unbeatable. They pushed them all the way, and Michael's will have to live in their faces for the full course of this final. They get the ball away. Ross Byrne moves it on. And quickly it's out wide. Great work on Lachlan. Little kick through. Clongos have defenders back. And a chance to come on the counter-attack. Powerful running from deep. Sebastian Fromm wearing the helmet. He missed the semi-final, but back in the side today.
Tackle and release. Separate.
McQuaid gets the ball back. Clongos hang one up. There's great height in that kick. Well watched all the way, well taken. And a good line, a defensive line following up by Clongos. Well, there was no way through there for St. Michael's. Holland gets the ball away. He'll look to his back row. Levy, Lawler and Murphy to carry the ball off with the ball.
Holding on.
Just not released in the tackle. Penalty for Clongos.
Well, what an opening minute to this game. Wonderful skill shown by both sides. Great kickoff by Ross Byrne. They won it back. They attacked out wide where the space is. They certainly learned from the semi-final watching Clongos play Taran Ure, where there is space out wide. Clongos' defence, though, was up for the challenge. And Sebastian Fromm, what a wonderful break out of his own 22. As you just watch here, the penalty conceded by St. Michael's. Early advantage given to Clongos, and Clongos have started slowly in both games, in the last two games, certainly against Castleknock in the quarterfinals, semis against Taran Ure, and Michael's a hope to exploit that.
Well, great possession from the line-out. Fromm came on the burst, was tackled and driven backwards, good tackle, St. Michael's. Clongos move the ball quickly. A penalty to St. Michael's. Good defence again.
Real abrasive physical tackling there from St. Michael's. Double teaming on Sebastian Fromm, the centre for Clongos, taken low and high, prevented the offload, indeed the knock on. Wonderful defence.
Well, Ross Byrne was banging the centre of the pitch. It's a very, very large playing surface at the RDS. He's found a good touch. Clongos, one good possession from their first line-out. The chance now for St. Michael's. Gavin Kelly to throw. We'll have a little look down the narrow side. Good work. Kelly attempts the handoff. Byrne gets across to make an important tackle. That was nicely worked by St. Michael's, and they get the penalty. And Ross Byrne has been in superb form with his place kicking in this cup.
Well, some wonderful, clever play by St. Michael's. They've obviously studied the videotapes of Clongos in the previous rounds, have identified where the space is. That ball was thrown to two in the line-out, which is normally not good ball for an attacking team. But they went then to short side, where they've identified where the space is, caused Clongos to give away the penalty, and now they're in a very good, strong attacking position.
Well, it was tight to the touchline, a long, long way from the post, and when you add, it was into the breeze. Ross Byrne wisely went for touch, and he's found an excellent touch inside the 22. Clongos get up to compete that time. St. Michael's half possession. Oh, good defensive mauling work from Clongos. They drove through. They managed to turn over the ball. They didn't get their hands on it, but they get to put into the scrum. That's good enough.
A big, physical, tough pack. Clongos. The driving ball started by, by Clongos. St. Michael's coming in here, the driving ball, but Clongos got stuck in, disrupted it, and turned the fence into a form of attack there. And this has been a very strong weapon for Clongos so far in the competition. Their scrum, they've dominated all opposition that they played against. Always secure a ball on their own put-in, and they've attacked the opposition's ball, getting a few against the head in the last few games. They need secure, quality possession.
Well, they win the penalty in the first scrum.
Binding, one.
Yeah, binding. Sending down a marker.
One.
And a very good touch, not much angle there. That's a great kick.
That's a wonderful kick. Precision there by Nicholson. So they watch the scrum again. Loose head just losing his bind. Andy Barr.
And St. Michael's have two huge props. They're both very tall men. As Clongos come away with possession. Awkward ball to take. Keenan did really, really well. It's away from McQuaid again. Brian Byrne kept the ball moving. Good work from Clongos, driving towards the halfway line. McQuaid goes left. One more time. This is the captain, Ed Byrne. St. Michael stopped that attack, but Clongos recycled the ball quickly.
No advantage. 13. No. Mark's in here.
Well, Rory O'Loughlin at straight offside. We're playing an advantage for Clongos. Nothing accrued. And they get the penalty now on halfway.
A lot of penalties so far in the game. I suppose both sides are really eager to slow down the opposition's ball any way they can. But going back to the original lineup by Clongos, wonderful take by Timmins jumping at four in the line out. And how often have we seen Ed Byrne pop up out wide for Clongos? They use him as a battering ram ball carrier, but he's so much more than that. He's got the skills of any back as well. He can offload. And he's very impressive. And Clongos use that weapon so effectively.
So great field position here for Clongos. Good possession, the line out. They attempt to set up the mall. It's broken away a little bit. St. Michael's had to react quickly to the ball carrier. Peeled away from the back. Good counter-rucking. Clongos get the ball away. They keep it tight. Now moved a little further. Byrne, the captain. Tackled high and low again. Good defence. Thrown a long way this time. McFerry, who just had to slow down and wait for the ball, gave the defensive line a chance, but he's done well. Ball is there once again. Byrne had to stretch back for that one. And Michaels were up really, really quickly. And the Michaels defence holds. They get to put into the scrum.
Well, I just wonder, is that the breeze catching the ball ever so slightly there? Michaels up so quick. Just watch Conor Quaid. McQuaid passed the ball out just a bit high. Brian Byrne had to delay his pass. Michaels up so quickly. Big hit going in and creating the turnover.
Good shove, has it been turned over? Great work, Clongos turnover ball in the scrum. Little pick and go by Timmins at the back, but he stopped. Now St. Michael's have to set the defence quickly. Almost an intercept. From just lost his footing. Bravely kept his eye on the ball. There's a Michael's defender flying up. Clongos have it once again.
Release two, red, blue. Stay high, most.
St. Michael's slow it down. McQuaid gets it going once again. The pass back inside. Five, that was read by St. Michael's. They've had to put in a ferocious amount of tackles early in this game. McQuaid dancing left and right. Swallowed up by the blue shirts. Brian Byrne way to the back of the ball. Passed. Rock's got it away. Michael's again up really, really quickly. They've pushed Clongos back to the 22. Once it slowed down, Clongos do very well. There's always two or three willing ball carriers available. It's slow coming back. If St. Michael's turned it over, Clongos protect the ball. McQuaid. A little quick shift interplay with Timmins. McQuaid was caught.
Hands off, Rook.
Did well to get the ball out of the tackle. And here come Clongers now. They go behind from. Michael's up quickly. There's a little bit of space here. Again, there's two St. Michael's tacklers.
From your side, White.
If Clongers can recycle quickly, there might be a little bit of space. John Wallace. The Palo Timmins it was stopped. McQuade comes to the narrow side. This is Wallace, the black scrum cap. Slid out quickly. Well, Andy Barr threw a boot at it, but it stuck on the Clongers' hand.
That's a mall.
It was just when St. Michael's maybe needed a little bit of luck.
Move. Stay.
Clongers continue the pressure. They go left here. Have they got a man over? Clever kick through. St. Michael's full back. Cameron Diamond.
Stand, Blue, wait.
He did well as he found touch. He's racing out. Close to the touchline, taken by Byrne. Great body position by Cameron Diamond. The fullback made the tackle, but Byrne did equally well to get the ball away. Little reverse pass. Was it flat? Referee allowing play to go on. Clongers bustled their way into the 22. Move the ball now. Taken at the second attempt, but it meant it was a big hit. Levy put in a huge tackle. A little bit scrappy there. St. Michael's forced to do a lot of defending in their own territory here. The ball is away now for Clongers once again. Bounced awkwardly. Levy up quickly. Great work by the St. Michael's captain. And a chance of relief. Michael's take the pick and dry. The ball is outside the 22. They just want to keep their hands on the ball for a few minutes. Levy's back on his feet. Donna Lawler comes out as well. They go to Lawless. He's been a brave carrier in the 2012 Senior Cup so far for St. Michael's.
Stay. No.
Now comes the box kick. It's into the wind, remember. Bobby Holland, he got a good contact on that. To cross halfway, but it just gives the ball back to Clongers. But great chase. The ball has gone loose. And the fly kicks somehow into the hands of the Clongers player. Shows great strength driving. Clongers got out that arrow side once again. McQuade, now he opens it up a little bit. Nicholson has a look, kicks crossfield. Just hanging up slightly. Bounce kind for it. St. Michael's. Good work, great work. Gallagher released, the tackle comes across. The ball's gone to touch. Well, brilliant, brilliant tackling back by Clongers. Great interplay by St. Michael's.
Well, it was a wonderful kick by Nicholson. It was right on the button, gave no angle here at all for Kelleher to attack from, but obviously nobody told Kelleher that as he, lovely sidestep, threw in the defender, releases his man outside, and Clongers good scrambling defence. They got across, but I'm exhausted from that. That phase of play must have gone on for about 4 or 5 minutes. Great ball retention by Clongers, and look at his hit. Leave him. Whoa. Stop Timmins offloading it, going backwards. Big hits coming in all over the place for St. Michael's, coming up very, very quickly, especially the men on the outside. And Levy again, once more, rushing up, securing possession. And something that Michael's are doing very well is that the outside man, be it the centres, are sprinting up, cutting off that avenue of attack for Clongers. So Clongers forced to attack inside and making it much more easier for the likes of Levy and Lawler, the back row for St. Michael's, to take down the opposition. So some wonderful ball skill by Clongers in attack, but great defence also by St. Michael's.
Kelvin Lee takes a chance to have a word with some players coming in as a ball carrier. Cameron Diamond is okay to continue. And the kick was blocked, came off a Clongers player. It was McQuade, the scrum half. Michael's go to the back of the line and it was up there for a long time. Byrne, they little change of direction. They're going to attack the narrow side. Kelleher once again, the little step didn't quite work that time. Clongers had the defence well lined up. Byrne, they have to come a little bit deeper.
Stand seven, wait.
Kick from now Rory Kavanagh. There's neither one thing or the other. Clongers come on the counter attack.
Tackle and release now.
McQuade. Clongers have extra men here if they can use the ball. A big hit comes in, forces the knock on. St. Michael's are certainly putting it about, Peter.
Well, they are up for the challenge. They knew they had to be if they're going to stop this Clongers team. They've seen what Taran Ure did, what Casnock did in the previous rounds. And look at this hit again. Who's that man Levy involved there? Not far off, but Wow, Roy Cavanagh at centre getting involved. Along with Lawler, Donal Lawler, number eight. Big, big hits, very, very physical, and forcing the turnover.
Oh, the parents of the Clongowes captain looking on interested. Two players on the field, of course, two sons, the twin brothers, Edward and Brian. St. Michael's upon the penalty in the scrum this time. Paul Haycock just evening up the score, do you think, Peter?
Well, do you know, I was just thinking about it there, that this is, it's been very much 50-50 so far. You would wonder, I suppose, Clongowes held on for the ball for much longer there a few minutes ago, but real parity here, no side other than Clongowes at the scrum. As we watch, Michael Scrum is going backwards there. It's under huge pressure.
Now Ross Byrne has found a fantastic touch. Playing into the wind, it's quite a stiff breeze. The longer St. Michael's keep Clongowes scoreless in the first half, the more they believe they go to Levy.
No release!
Just lost his footing trying to set something up on the narrow side. St. Michael's have attacked that area three times now. Byrne throwing some weight in. Coleman caught the ball and was driven backwards. Needs to work hard to protect the ball here. And the St. Michael support players went off their feet. Prevented Clongowes playing the ball penalty.
Well, it's a case of right back at you. I suppose Clongowes in defence there, doing exactly to Michaels what Michaels were doing to Clongowes. Big hits going in. Because the player was caught behind the gain line, the momentum was with Clongowes going forward. St. Michael's forced to try and seal off the ball from Clongowes getting their hands on it, and referee quite rightly deeming it a penalty.
Mark Nicholson finds another good touch. And here's the pressure. Coleman is number five. He's forced backwards.
You see there, Michael Spear losing his footing, still sealing off the ball. He can't do that.
Good catch line, a huge pass out. And they go the short one. Timmins just had to slow down a little bit. Unable to get forward momentum. Here come Clongowes once again.
That's finally what's in help. Stay.
Good handling, opening up a little bit of space. Clongowes drive out to the 10-metre line. That was Wallace. Sebastian Fromm.
Step back.
Did well, kept the ball moving forward. Nicholson blocked down. Whose hands are going to go up? St. Michael's half possession. Lawler the cup, the number eight.
That's fine.
Michael's just couldn't move the ball quick enough. They might have a chance here. Clever kick through by Bobby Holland. But it bounced up nice and high. Clongowes had a chance to wait for it and clear. They haven't found touch. Ball taken safely by Cameron Diamond. Uses Kean Kelleher, big, big man for a winger. Byrne, flat pass to Levy.
No release!
Dropped his head, went straight into two big tackles, but the ball is there for St. Michael's. They got back to Cameron Diamond, thought about kicking. Carrying the ball in one hand, that's always a bit risky.
Step back, Purple. Stay. Wait.
Kicked through this time from Rory Kavanagh. Again, it sits up.
It's outside.
The surface is really, really firm out there. That bounces in play. You can see how high the bounce is. Just gives the defenders a moment. Rory Kavanagh did really well to stay on his feet as the tackles came in. Just gave his supporting players time to come back.
Far side, wait. No.
St. Michael's using the long body of Ross Maloney to give their scrum half a bit of space for the box kick. It's great height on it. Off of Clongowes' hand, it's gone backwards.
Hands off now, Rook!
Timmins gathered at the second attempt. Clongowes have the ball again, but they're on their own 10-meter line.
It's really behind them.
Box kick again, it's blocked down. And it's found its way to touch. A couple of kicks have been blocked down, Peter.
Yeah, Michael's putting real pressure on the Clongowes kickers. I thought Nicholson actually was making the right choice earlier on when he was kicking for the corner. But Michael's up very, very quickly. The block then happened. And here once again, we see McQuaid. Yeah. The tall figure there, I think it was Ross Maloney. You see Nicholson here, the earlier block down. Andy Barr, loose head, getting around the park, and that's been a feature of both sides, really, is their front five have been getting around the park, making big hits, tackles, but also ball carrying. And there you can see looking to block down kicks. And Patter Timmins, well, he's had a great game so far, beating the line out, securing possession for Clongowes, or just getting around the park, both in attack and defence. And I suppose, what, 18 minutes gone so far, no points on the board, but it's been a very interesting game. It's helter-skelter, it's frantic, the pendulum is swinging both ways, both sides getting possession and returning it again to the opposition. You just don't know which way this is going to go.
Well, it's hard to believe there's 18 minutes gone already, and also hard to believe there's been no score. It's been frantic, it's been a little bit loose at times, but the defences are definitely on top. Line out for Clongowes, about halfway between the halfway line of their own 22. Byrne throws. Robert Daly gets up. Ball held at the second attempt. Again, those tackles coming in.
It's all right.
So Michael's managed to get a trailing arm as the ball carrier tried to slip away, and they come down looking at the win, the penalty. Brilliant work by St. Michael's. John Alola gets the pat in the back from his teammates.
Well, it started from a big hit by Josh Murphy, number six for St. Michael's. Went in low, but pumped the legs, drove the man backwards. Donal Lawler came through also, as we watch here. Big hit there. St. Michael's, see, caught behind the gain line. Momentum is with St. Michael's. Murphy with the big hit, and then Donal Lawler driving through, forcing the penalty. Great defence.
No, back half a step.
Ross Byrne getting ready to have the shot at goal. Dan Levy's parents looking on. Well, how they'd love their son's side to win today.
Yeah, it's fine, there's a man down injured.
He was involved in the final 2 years ago. Ross Byrne, he's been in superb form. This could be a real tester for him. He's not far inside the 10-meter line. It's into the breeze. He's caught it nicely, but it's holding up in the wind. It comes down just on the try line.
Stand purple, one, wait. Wait, one. No,
the ball doesn't find touch. Levy, the captain, racing at the Clongowes defensive line. The ball just tapped out of his grasp. Knock on. Scrum for Clongowes, and they get the chance to maybe regroup again. But that kick with into the wind. How far is he going to kick it with the wind behind him in the second half, Peter?
Well, he had direction. It certainly was just the distance. And we watched Dan Levy going into contact. Ball in two hands. Puts it into one to take the kiss. But Clongowes getting stuck in and tackling the ball there. That's what they did. They tackled the ball, forcing it to squirt out. Stop the offload as we watch the kick here. As we said, had direction. It's just that breeze is very, very strong. Great attempt though by Ross Byrne.
Great. Touch. Your heads can't touch. Just run out yourself, or I'll throw it out for you. That's fine. No. They have to step sideways. Sideways. Your heads can't be head to head.
Paul Haycock just laying down the law to the two sets of front rows. You've seen the professional game a lot, the props line up head to head. And the kids will always copy what they see at the top level of the game. And Haycock doesn't like it. The ball goes back to the base of the Clongowes scrum. Little pick from Timmins. Tackles in again quickly. Dan Levy got Timmins low. Prevented any progress. McQuaid gets the ball away. Clongowes keeping it tight.
Stay.
McQuaid goes a bit deeper.
Stands purple. Eight stand. Now play.
Great height on that kick, but nicely taken. Michaels have a good line here if they can move the ball. Kelleher sees a little bit of space. Well tackled. Brilliant tackle. McFerry coming across. It's there once again. I'll say Michaels got up. Almost crack. Holland the scrum half. This is Lawless. Tackle. The tackler doesn't release. And Lawless pulls the penalty for St. Michael's. Well, this one's about 8 metres closer. I think Byrne will fancy a shot here. As you see the replay.
Yeah, look at this. Look how hard Michael's worked to get back for the counter-attack. So they have numbers, but Clongowes drift off. They don't commit too early. Great tackle by McVerry getting across, but they need to slow down St. Michael's ball, because look how quickly they are in recycling it. Initial hit went in by Daly for Clongowes. And yeah, you can see, I think that was Sebastian Fromm, was it? Was the tackler taking Lawless down to ground, didn't release him, and giving away the penalty. But again, great counter-attacking by St. Michael's, and Ross Byrne, this should be in his distance.
Well, the first one just came down under the blue spot on the crossbar.
just needs to do exactly the same again. He doesn't want to force this one. Short step, he's caught that one perfectly through the posts. The first score of the 2012 Leinster Schools Cup final goes to St Michael's and goes to Ross Burns. Here we see it again. What a brilliant kick, Peter.
Well, you're right, John. He didn't force it, kept the head down, plenty of height there. Wind didn't take the ball away across the pitch, which you might have expected. And St. Michael's 3 points on the board, and every point is vital. We've seen that obviously in every game, but I think this is going to be a very, very close game, and both sides must take their opportunities here. But just as the kick went over, you can see Donal Lawler for St. Michael's as he was running back, getting the crowd behind, waving to them to get the atmosphere up, get behind the players more. They're obviously responding to it.
Well, Clongos get possession from the restart. Daniel O'Byrne, great take. Quaid races forward, gets the pass away. Nicholson to Froome. Good offload by Froome. Great support coming on a shoulder from McFerry. Clongos looking to respond quickly. They come to the right-hand side. The fullback is up. McFarland is a dangerous man with ball in hand as well. Good work from Stephen Keelan, stepping away, pumps his legs, good strength. St Michael's compete for the ball, but it's there for Clongos. They go to Byrne. Lovely feint and show the ball, pops it up nicely. Timmins, hauled to the ground by Bobby Holland. Clongos attack once again. O'Byrne, big, powerful prop forward, driving. Clongos 8 metres out from the St Michael's line. Referee's arm is out. Advantage, and it's a penalty to Clongos. Well, that's a ferocious effort from Clongos right from the restart, Peter.
Yeah, referee being consistent here, telling the St Michael's players you did not roll away, therefore the penalty is being conceded. But that came from a Clongos attack which had pretty much everything in it. You had Brian Byrne displaying a show and go which any head half would have been proud of. Low driving positions by Clongos. Just see Daniel O'Byrne there piling forward, supported by his teammates. Low body positions.
Just make sure they don't come off the line.
And tackler didn't roll away. He was obviously trying to stop the ball coming back for Clongos because they were living off the quick ball, putting the St. Michael's defence under an awful lot of pressure.
Yeah, I heard you.
Conor Mahoney now, first chance of the game for him. Not the easiest position in the world for a right-footed kicker.
Well, the wind is helping. It's coming over his left shoulder. He's done a sensible thing here. He's brought everything back so it's all in sunshine. He doesn't have to worry about the shade. He sends it on its way. It's a big thump. Has it gone through? Just to the right hand side and wide. You heard the referee shout, no, no. And he cut it nicely, Peter, just a little bit over the direction.
He just wanted to, given the height to the breeze, play a factor in this. I don't think it was actually on or was in going in the correct direction, to be honest, to start off with. But Clongos won't panic. They've been behind in the last two games. They've come back. They know if they just keep putting on the pressure, doing the basics well, they will be there, but they're about to come the end of the game, and they just need to get some points on the board now.
Great height on that restart. Wallace underneath it, it went backwards. McQuaid, goes to Byrne. St. Michael's up really, really quickly once again. McQuaid gets it away again. Nicholson pulls it back. McFarlane up from fullback, but again, that rushing defence from St. Michael's is causing Clongos problems. Clongos go back to the reliable Brian Byrne, but again, St. Michael's get the ball carrier, force him backwards a little bit. Timmins, little show. Didn't go back to McQuaid on that occasion. McQuaid gets it out to Nicholson. Nicholson kicked back against the grain. Well read by Cameron Diamond. He's inside his 22. He has the freedom to go straight for touch. The breeze just keeping that one in play. And a great burst tight down to the line. Brilliant tap tackle. The ball goes loose on the ground. Wow. What pace out on the wing, but a great tap tackle.
Well, what a break by McFarland. Diamond was very well positioned. It was a lovely kick to start off with. McFarland, look at that. The feint goes for it, and it's a tap tackle, is when you're not expecting it. There's a little bit of a shock there, and you're not prepared for the hit. And that's when the ball can tend to spill out. But what pace, electric pace. Mike Long is unfortunately the ball spilling forward.
Touch.
St. Michael's scrummage in their own half.
Come up. You work to stay straight. And you work to stay straight and keep that line tight with him.
Okay, Haycock again. Just having a word with the two front rows. Trying to go down, and St. Michael's get the decision penalty. Well, Jamie Lawless looks like he needs some help here. Hope he's okay.
Well, the physical effort from scrums, the amount of pressure that goes through a prop's back at scrum time. I think at the professional level, it's something like, is it 5 tons of pressure goes through the front rows forwards back? So even at this level, there's an awful lot of pressure. And it can take its toll, especially when you're under the type of stress that they are from this Clongowes front row. He's had a good game so far, though, Jamie Lawless. Been very noticeable in the loose, but in the scrums, he's done well from a very shaky start by the St. Michael's pack.
Here we see a replay of the scrum. That's where it went down. They got the penalty. Still lots of noise around the stadium from both sets of supporters. 3-0 the margin. Clongowes are trailing as the clock heads towards half an hour.
But it's been a wonderful open game as well. Both sides really choosing to play with the ball in hand rather than kicking it. Though at the same time, they've been varying the play. Both at halves, I thought, have been kicking well when they've had to and been mixing it up well to make what it has been a very entertaining game so far.
Jump by Ross Maloney in the line-out. Levy with the carry once again. Lawler comes in to do a bit of clearing out. This is Lawless. Clearly back to fitness, full fitness after that little bit of treatment. Quickly recycled, Byrne goes flat this time. The gap almost opens up. Brilliant tackle by McFerry and O'Loughlin. The referee says it was forward. He was well in line. It's a better view than we have, Peter.
Well, it looked incredibly flat, we put it that way. I think it was edging. We just watch here. The beat of getting a ball, yeah. You see, it doesn't help when the out half, Ross Byrne is running backwards. It always gives a bit of an optical illusion. If it is, it's possibly a half a yard forward there. But because it's flat when O'Loughlin took it, the defence had very little time to react, although McFerry did extremely well in the circumstances.
Judge. Pause. Engage.
Quick heel, Timmins controls at the back. McQuaid has come to the narrow side, that's where Timmins heads, looking for support. Tried to spin out of the tackle, but Levy and Lawler dealt with that. Great hands from Clongowes. The big hits continue to come in from St. Michael's. Levy once again. How many times has he put a Clongowes player on the ground? Counter up comes from St. Michael's, and they get the decision. Oh, they're really, really putting pressure on the ball carrier. And it's paying dividends, Peter.
It all started to look at Levy. Does this man know how to do small tackles? Well, I don't think so. Clongowes recycle it back, and then just watch, gets tackled here, Timmins in midfield, and it's Lawless who comes in. Just watch now, gets low. Pushing forward, that's it. Levy again have got in there, and it's been wonderful play at the break then by Michaels. They are contesting for everything, and they're now in a good, strong attacking position, just on the 22. Clongowes 22.
Cheers, Benji.
Ross Byrne's found a good touch. Gavin Kelly to throw, five-man line out. A lot of chopping and changing. Michaels go to the front. Wasn't tapped back to the scrum half.
Crossing.
They're just in their efforts to protect the player coming down. They can see the penalty. It's getting picked up a lot by referees now, Peter.
It is. You see it more and more. It's something that wouldn't have in the past, certainly. And Haycock, the referee, Paul Haycock, has had a good game so far. been quite a few penalties by both sides, but still we've had a flowing game, and you know that's what you'd hope for from a referee, that he lets play continue. But in that position, I suppose Michaels did have the ball. There was a legal crossing, and therefore a penalty, obviously, to Clongos.
Brian Byrne throws, tapped down quickly. Beautiful pass. First hand, just went off the fingertips.
Nine release.
And Mark Nicholson in midfield, but Clongos still have the ball. The referee shouted and went backwards.
So offside, it was a tackle. No offside.
Brian did well, making some more metres for Clongos. Again, the big thumping tackles come in from St. Michael's. McQuaid, Nicholson pulls it back a little bit. That one's forward. Now the whistle blows. Brian McNeese is the touch judge on this side. I don't know whether he pressed a little button on the flag or not, but he never moved once he saw the ball spilled.
Yeah, just a lack of precision by Clongos. Passing possibly hasn't been as crisp as they would want it. Ball going behind the players at times.
2 minutes.
Players taking their eyes off the ball also. They haven't helped themselves, and Clongos can't afford to be making these mistakes because they've St. Michael's defence is coming up very, very quickly. So Clongos players can see the Michael's players in the corner of their eye, and it's maybe making them a little bit anxious.
Hold it, purple, hold it!
Big shove from the Clongos eight. The ball is away. Bobby Holland did well. Byrne flat pass that time, it was just a little bit low. Referee's arm is out, no advantage coming to Clongos. Whistle blows, scrum for Clongos. And maybe one last chance for the men from Kildare to get something on the board before the break.
I just wonder, are both teams underestimating the strength of this breeze that's out there? Because they're both trying wide passes. Very difficult to control, to have the ball land where you need it to when a player is running on at full pace. And now that's both sides having made handling errors in the last couple of minutes, which if they kept the passes maybe shorter, kept the supporting player a little bit closer also, it might help themselves.
Crunch. Touch.
Paul Haycock changes sides, comes around to the blind side to watch what's going on.
Shoulder.
McQuaid gets the ball away. Nicholson, little reverse pass. Good break on the loop, looking for support. Great handling from this time. Can he release? Great little pop-up pass to Wallace. McQuaid thought about coming right. He's gone left. Is there an overlap here? Byrne, great release. McFerry just lost his footing in the tackle, but it clongers into the 22. St. Michael's. Some vital defending to do. There's going to be a penalty to come. A lazy runner coming back for St. Michael's. Just blocked off the pass. Clongos still have possession. McQuaid goes left again. Byrne. Brian Byrne tried to sweep around the covering tackle. And was hauled to the ground. And now Clongos at the full width of the pitch to come. They have a penalty advantage still. And no advantage accruing, so they get that penalty. And that will could well bring the end of the half. But it's a shot at goal, and it's a scorable chance, Peter.
Well, some exciting attacking play by Clongos. Very elaborate backline move, first of all, when McQuaid got the ball from blind, took it on, we went out wide to Ed Byrne, and again, he showed some skills that you just would not expect. Look at McQuaid, just watch him. See the way he hid there, took it forward. St. Michael's has shot up quickly on the outside, creating a dog leg. Fromm did very well, and just good support play. And as we watch, when the ball went out wide, just watch, yeah, Lawless, who's offside there, in the path of the pass.
Once it's dead, it's over, all right?
But good play by Clongos, going the same way, putting Michaels under pressure and creating a situation now where O'Mahony.
Conor Mahoney missed with one so far. Ball blows off the tee. Referee Paul Haycock says he's okay to replace it. He's told the players it's the end of the half the next time the ball goes dead. Oh, St. Michael's just want to concentrate for one more moment in case it comes off the upright. But Clongos will take the 3 points if they can get them. Mahoney sends it on its way. The touch judges raise their flags as Paul Haycock blows the half-time whistle. It's been low scoring, but it's been fantastically entertaining at the Audiers at half-time as their sides trot back to the trainers and to get into the huddle. We have seen some superb rugby. Low scoring, as I said, with a half-time score. It's Clongos 3, St. Michael's 3.
All even, doesn't get any closer. It is a cup final. What else did you expect? Second half coming up and analysis after the break. Stay with us. Very welcome back. Despite all the running rugby we've seen, the only scores are the two penalties. One for St Michael's early in the half and then this one after the bell at half-time. 3-3. It's a very strong wind coming down the field that will favour St Michael's in the second half as the players move back from their half-time break. We'll come back to live pitches there, and we'll go back to our commentators at the RDS, John Forrest and Peter McKenna.
You're very welcome back to the RDS. The side's just getting ready for the second half. The score, St Michael's 3, Clongos Wood College 3. It couldn't be closer. With me's Peter McKenna. It's been a fabulous first half. How are they going now, do you think?
Well, God, it's such an even battle, and it has been a battle, real physical war between these two sides, very little in it, and I suppose the only real advantage that you could say either side has is being in the Congo scrum. But in this half, St Michael's do have the wind, and I think it will be a very telling factor come the end of the game.
Mark Nicholson gets the second half underway. Congo's put on huge pressure after the St Michael's score in the first half by getting possession from the restart. This time St Michael's secure it. Box kick is sent downfield, and we may see early in this half how much St Michael's will use the strong breeze. But it's Clongers on the attack here, a little bit of space opening up. Rory O'Loughlin gets across and makes a good tackle. And Clongers have the ball. McQuaid gets it as far as Wallace. Good step from Wallace, but double tackled once again. Ross Maloney there to help out with the tackle. McQuaid has a little snipe.
Hands off now!
Michael's compete for the ball on the ground. The referee shouts hands off. And Clongos have secured it. Brian Byrne, little reverse pass to his brother. Edward just about held onto it at the fingertips. Brian, Daniel O'Byrne protecting the ball. McQuaid back on his feet. Change of direction here. The call comes from Nicholson. But again, St. Michael's are up really, really quickly. Rory Kavanagh with the tackle that time. McQuaid gets the ball away. Clongers attack down that narrow side.
Four in the side.
Got it from Finnegan. Oh, Clongers coming in from the side. Just watch the twin brothers here. Oh, that's Brian popping it up to Ed. It's wonderful, isn't it, Peter?
What skill. It's just amazing to watch at this level. I really am amazed just how great the basic skills are, but St. Michael's are slowing down the Clongers ball, and it's a little bit dangerous, I think, to support winners getting isolated, not getting near the ball carrier.
Great, you just see the pace again there of Max McFarland at fullback. Michael's got up and made tackles. They're still working hard. Coleman there. The tackle low. Byrne. Head Byrne to Ryan Byrne on that occasion. It's really like having an extra set of back row forwards in the back with Edward Byrne, Brian Byrne, and Daniel O'Byrne. The Clongos front row. They can all run, they can all pass. Now Clongers throw the ball a little bit wide. Keelan releases Daly. McQuaid keeps the ball going left. Byrne tackled on halfway. So Michael's thought about grabbing the ball. They have a chance there. Referee's arm goes out. Advantage to Clongers. McQuaid thought about going back into Brian Byrne on that occasion. This is Ed Byrne. A bit of space opens up. Looking for support. fainted the pass, took the tackle, the ball thrown wide, surely there's a chance here for a try. Good step, Conor Mahoney just couldn't get back inside, the ball has gone loose. Knocked on by St. Michael's, I thought it might have gone loose off the Clongos player. Interesting to see this again, Peter.
Well, that attack by St. Clongos, it had great angles, it had very good support runners, good linking. Fair enough, St. Michael's got back in good scrambling defence, but look at this, this was slow ball, and look at this line that Ed Byrne chose, did fantastically well, sucked in two defenders, then ball Ed wide to Mahoney, Michael's get across well. Good scramble defence, he had four defenders and only one Clongos player in support of his own man. Now, Clongos scrum has been a dominant scrum, they're 5 yards from St. Michael's line.
Ball back to the feet of Pather Timmins, McQuaid a little bit high. Ball moved inside, little reverse pass. Clongos just taking their eye off the ball, it's flying around. They need to get the clever little pass away, the ball kicked, rubber kicked downfield. Clongos need to watch this one. Mahoney was back but lost his footing. Three blue shirts swarm all over him. St. Michael's don't want to give away a penalty here. They're in to compete for the ball. Desperate effort from Clongos to get back. Have they secured possession? They have, but they're back of their own 22. Brian Byrne. Tackled that time by Ross Maloney. And Clongos just slowing things down. They have to build again. McQuaid gets it back. Long clearance downfield, and it hangs up well on the wind. Cameron Diamond had to wait a long time, but he made a safe catch.
Now hands off! Step back!
Well, St. Michael's have a lot of bodies. In on that rook. They go to Josh Murphy. Murphy has done well. The support came. Go to the narrow side once again. Lawless. Well, he's taken well. Tackle low by Timmins. That prevented the plop forward really getting any legs pumping. Timmins up on Ross Byrne, but he set up a brilliant Gary Owen. Great jump and take.
Hands off, Rook. 13 offside.
Rory O'Loughlin has just strayed offside. The penalty's been taken quickly by McQuaid. Breaks away up to halfway, then it stopped. And now St. Michael's get the penalty ball, not released, I think.
It has been a feature so far that the ball carrier for Clongos is getting isolated and support runners are not getting in. Just watch here, there's four defenders, and that man, Dan Levy, God, he reminds you of Sam Warburton. He really is, he's that mobile, that quick. And Clongos struggling now to get out of their half. I'm not quite sure if you go back to that scrum, which is 5 yards from St. Michael's line, I'm not quite sure why Clongos went wide like that when St. Michael's had all their men in defence up in the line. Full back is in the defensive line. Makes it very difficult to attack out wide, and in fairness, Michael's poured through and they got themselves in a very good attacking position.
Clongos get up, great work by Robert Daly to steal the ball in that line out. McQuaid goes to Byrne.
Hands off, Rook!
And McQuaid comes back to the narrow side, it'll show from Nicholson, good feed from Nicholson.
Hands away,
but he's well wrapped up by Andy Barr. Referee's arm is out, another penalty for Clongos.
You weren't the first man in, you've got to listen to me. You weren't the first man in.
Well, Captain Dan Levy, the last one to get back to his feet.
Perfect.
And Nicholson has a chance to get some territorial advantage here.
10 purple off, yes.
Finds touch at about halfway between 22 and
number
halfway
10.
Line.
10, change. 10, change. Time off there, Begsy.
Oh, Paul Haycock will stop the clock.
10.
I think there's going to be a couple of substitutions.
Just wait. Time's off.
Mark Nicholson heading to the side. James Sullivan coming in his place.
OK, Bexley, time on, please. You're here for me, please. Straight. 6.
Well, Sullivan will slot in at scrum half, I expect, and they will move McQuaid out to the 10 slot. That's McQuaid. Great work to take that. It was a difficult one to take. Has good support from Keane O'Donoghue. Clongo's been driven backwards, but they've come up with possession again.
That's fine, nobody
McFarlane
there.
McFarlane dancing left and right. He really is a hard man to get a hold of and to drag to the ground. And Michaels eventually did that, but Clongo's have got the ball all the way wide. Conor Mahoney
step
back away from the touchline to keep that one alive. Ball thrown long to Byrne. As soon as he gets the ball, there's a St. Michael's player snapping at his ankles. Sullivan gets the ball, moving into set chance. It's taken. It's going to race away. Chris Fagan is going to score for St. Michael's. Try beside the post. Intercept try. The St. Michael's fans have gone bananas at the ODS. But an intercept try always causes excitement. But what pace, Peter?
Well, he timed it perfectly, Chris Fagan. He held back, then sprinted forward. It was a long pass. It was held in the breeze as we watch it here. Just held in the breeze, but timed perfectly. Never took his eye off the ball, Chris Fagan. And the Clongers were not going to catch him. It was Tommy Bowe-esque. Wonderful try. Clongers had been caught behind the gain line time and time again there by St. Michael's. They were forced to do something extravagant to get out of their half. They chose to go wide with the pass. And that man, Fagan, well, he was onto it. Did extremely well.
Well, Ross Byrne with the conversion attempt. One out of two so far. No delay. Yes. Just to the right-hand side of the post. He didn't come back too far. He's out of the 2 points. And that really is a big shot in the arm for St. Michael's. They have a seven-point lead. Here we see it again from behind the goal. What a steal, one-handed. And then just pinned back his ears. No one was going to catch Chris Fagan from there.
Well, St. Michael's, sorry, in defence, been doing that all day. They've been sprinting up hard outside, out wide. To go wide like that by Clongos with a big, long pass like that, it's very risky. It can pay dividends, but not that time. Chris Fagan was very much onto it and made Clongos pay for their risk.
Clongos 3, St. Michael's 10. Ball bouncing around awkwardly inside the St. Michael's 22.
Hands off there, Rook!
St. Michael's have done well to get the ball back almost to the 22-metre line. Setting up a long channel of bodies at the back of that ruck. Just gives the scrum half an extra bit of time, an extra bit of space.
Step back,
doesn't take the box kick that time.
Burn.
Sends a huge Gary Owen downfield out to halfway. McFarland.
Right,
I think it's a risky tactic kicking the ball to Max McFarland. He's going to sneak through at some stage, you think. McQuaid caught. Good strength by the scrum half, who's now playing at 10. Byrne was taken. Sullivan with a little kick through. It's a clever kick, man. He's a lot of pace. The ball wins the race to the touchline, though, but a good kick, Peter.
Well, he has an eye for space, James Sullivan. Michaels were up very flat in the fence. There was nobody hanging back. There's nobody back there at all. And if it had rolled into touch, well, Michaels were in an awful lot of trouble there. But good spot where the space was by Jack Sullivan. James
Time
Sullivan.
Off, three blue change.
Well, looks like St. Michael's are making a substitution. Pat on the back for Jamie Lawless. Dennis Coulson will be the prop forward replacement. James Lawless, 45 minutes. He has had an excellent game for St. Michael's. Coulson came on as a substitute in the second round, scored a couple of tries. St. Michael's will love to see him do it again. The referee's shouting at the Clongos players to get back. Box kick does come this time. Past halfway. Clongos have three back. There's a roar of forward pass. It was straight in front of us. I think it was okay. Clongos unable to find a way through. Maybe rushing things a little bit. O'Donoghue tried to get the pass away. And a good kick in return by Clongos. It's going to get into the 22. McFarland is back there. He has plenty of time. Ops to kick. That's into a strong breeze. He finds touch okay. But it's difficult kicking into that wind, especially coming, collecting a bouncing ball.
Well, it was a very good chase by St. Michael's. There's three players in front of him. Max McFarland, no other option really. I think then to go for the kick. And it's a strong breeze. And you just see even from the box kick, first of all, by St. Michael's, it carried about 50, 60 yards.
St. Michael's line out. They're in the Clongos half. good attacking position here. The throw just went forward off the first tap. Josh Murphy will be called back. I'm sure he thought he was away.
Time off.
Oh, we see the steel just came off the fingertips in the line-out. Murphy reacted quickly.
Yeah, I think it was Coleman was reaching, had to reach right across, became unbalanced to support, or his lifters weren't able to keep him supported, and he fell awkwardly. Very athletic jump by Coleman, all the same. And it's a pity for St. Michael's because he had done very well to get into the half here. The good attacking position, you can see the backline formation that they had was very, very good.
You see it again, he got up, it just came off the back of his hand. You can see the jolt as he lands. It was okay. Josh Murphy, as I said, was racing away. He had the try line in his sights. Andy Coleman is back on his feet. There's the Clongo support. They still believe, Peter.
And why not? There's only one try in it. They look very potent and dangerous with the ball in hand, Clongo. They just need to get back up the other end of the park, though.
Well, Dennis Coulson into the front row for St. Michael's. 17 on this side. James Sullivan wearing 20, also a substitute. He's putting it in for Clongo's. Timmins gets it away to Sullivan. They go back to McQuaid. McQuaid waited, but he hasn't found his man. Mahoney had to race back. He's hoofed that downfield. Diamond is underneath it. Good catch. Thought about the drop goal from a long way out. And St. Michael's just forcing things a little bit. The referee's whistle blows, went forward, I think, over Clongo's hand. And a let off there for St. Michael's, maybe.
Yeah, if I was St. Michael's, I'd be just doing the simple things well here, taking no risks, no 50-50 ball. You can see what Cameron was trying to do. He did have the overlap. But very strong, quick defense by Clongo's. It was a good chase on the kick. Lucky for St. Michael's, it was a knock-on because I think they were under extreme pressure and danger there.
And it's a knock-on that teams often get away with the hand involved in the tackle. It's often not spotted, so Paul Haycock did well. Ball back through Lawler. St. Michael's get it away. Ross Byrne gets it nicely back to O'Loughlin. Just had to change his footing. St. Michael's change of direction. Crossfield kick. Cameron Diamond is in the line. Just overcooked it a little bit.
Unlucky, unlucky. There was nobody there at all. It's that breeze again. It's just very easy to underestimate just how strong it is. It will catch a ball. It will give it an extra 10, 15 yards distance. As we watch here, great switch of play by Diamond. Nobody there at all. Congas are up very flat, waiting for the attack.
You're kicking on the run as well. It gets it another 5 yards or so, doesn't it?
Yeah, and it's the adrenaline. It's a bit more force behind the kick.
Steal by St. Michael's in the line-out. Clongo's through to compete for the ball. And it's there. Bobby Holland gets it away. Ross Byrne. Well, that's spinning viciously in the air. Good chase. Great take by O'Loughlin. Did he hold on to it as he hit the deck? He did. St. Michael's get it away. Ross Byrne chip. It's half blocked down. Squirt sideways. Back as far as Fagan, the try scorer. St. Michael's can't start taking risks and making mistakes now. It's only 7 points the lead. Their tails are up. And one mistake. That's how they got the score against Clongo's, the intercept. If they were to concede a similar score at this stage, it really would have been. Super blow back for Clongo's, but that's a perfect kick. Finds touch. Mahoney's taking it quickly. McFarland fancies his chance getting around the wing. He doesn't. The ball's gone loose. And things are beginning to go St. Michael's way, Peter.
Well, you have to understand when you're in a back three and you're faced with that type of breeze, running the ball is far more preferable. And especially when you've just turned over your last line-out, sometimes the quick line-out is far more preferable because Michael's our attacking group. But just look at this, a look, a fantastic skill. Never took his eye off the ball. Very brave. He was facing front on when he did that, which can be potentially quite a risky thing to do, but they did extremely well. And McFarland and Mahoney looked to break out, but Michael's, look at it, up very, very quickly. That's just attitude. That's great commitment by St. Michael's, chasing everything today. And Congas, you just feel maybe are forcing it a little bit at the moment.
St. Michael's players beginning to feel the effects. seem to be getting treated for cramp. So Michael support, well, in fine voice now, happy with what they're seeing. There's the best part of 20 minutes still to go. There's a long way left in this final.
Is that going to change, Dave?
Well, I don't want to labour the point, but Clongos have been behind in their last two games. The times they've looked out and gone, it was a lost cause. But they came back, they have belief, they have confidence in their ability, and why not? They've shown it today, and again, it's just doing the simple things well. They just need to get the ball in hand and find a space.
Rory O'Loughlin back on his feet. Here we see what happened again. That was the chase, a brilliant, brilliant catch. He was a little bit off balance and hit hard in the tackle. Did one ankle get pinned to the ground. Kelvin Lee and Bernard Jackman looking on. They're getting some substitutes ready. Well, Rory O'Loughlin is staying out there. Say he'd stay out if he'd a broken leg.
Oh, that's it, you just don't want to come off the park. And it's amazing what adrenaline does as well. You don't feel the aches and pains until the final whistle goes.
Restart then, scrum for St. Michael's. They're in the Clongos. 22, great attacking position here. The full width of the pitch to work with. Big shove from Clongos. They've turned it over. Great work by the Clongos pack. And will that effort from the eight big men just give their side the lift they need?
Step away, two.
Kick for touch, just taken inside the touchline. Big tackle comes in. That's the sort of thing St. Michael's have been doing to Clongos. Levy was unable to wriggle his way through. Ross Byrne sees a little bit of space. Which side of the corner flag is it going to go? Oh, the wrong side out over the dead ball line. Just got an unlucky bounce, I think. It was a nice idea.
Yeah, it's that oval-shaped ball. It can go anyway.
Scrum.
But it's the right idea. It's looking to pin them back in the corner. And again, against the head. Look at that drive by Clongos. The power that's as eight, as a unit. And you wonder, is this possibly a turning point for them to get the ball against the head in what was a very dangerous attacking position for St. Michael's?
14 change.
Well, Chris Fagan has been called aside after getting the intercept try. He heads to the side. And in his place comes Adam Levy. Well, Chris Fagan, what an impact he's had in this game with his try. He gets a hook from his coach, or from his teammates. Sullivan, a little kick down the tram lines. That's too heavy as well, just overcooked. And play comes all the way back. Just sense Clongers need a little bit of magic, something to go their way, Peter, here.
It's unrelenting pressure by St. Michael's. They're doing well. They're pinning Clongers back in the corner when Clongers look to break out. Kicking it straight into touch, or there's little knock-ons. They're not doing themselves any favour here, but they do need something just to break for them, whether it's a bounce of a ball or just something.
Ross Maloney rises at the front of the line-out, secures possession for St. Michael's. Andy Barr with a pick and drive, quickly forced backwards. He gets his body position the right way around, gets the ball back. Holland gets it back, Byrne. Oh, we've seen him kicking well, so far. It's the first time he's attacked with ball in hand.
He's not holding it. Leave it alone, Purple. The ball is there. It's not him. Eight move. He's there. Ball's there.
Slower ball this time for St. Michael's, but they've options left and right. And go to the pot of big men. Josh Murphy into contact. Good clearing out work. Byrne. Great little break. Cabinets into space. Great tracking back. Big tackle. And Clongos turned it over here. St. Michael's drive in. No, St. Michael's held on to it. Byrne moves it on. No way through that time. And St. Michael's have piles of players to the right-hand side. Just accidental offside, though. Tried to rush it a little bit, maybe.
Well, Kavanagh did so well to find a hole in what has been an impregnable wall of defence for Clongos. Look at this, his timing. It's dragging defenders across, and that speed and power, and it's a mismatch. Back against forward, pace. Yeah, just ran into his man ever so slightly.
Touch.
Michaels that time. Might have been better to move the ball wide. Good scrum here from St. Michaels. Ball is back. Sullivan did well. Gets the ball out to Fromm.
Step back, 12.
Sullivan again, little snipe, but there's just too many blue shirts there.
That's a maul. Eight, out you go, eight. Eight in the side.
Oh, Donna Lawler came in just eight, a little bit over-enthusiastic. Referee shouted at him to get out, he didn't, and it's a penalty to Clongos.
Well, you might wonder why Clongos are running it so much, but if they look up, they will see a St. Michael's player fielding the space where they plan to kick to. Very good fielding, very good positioning by St. Michael's. It's making Clongos keep the ball tight, keep running it, and they've got a fantastic defence that's coming up, and it's containing St. Michael, or containing Clongos very well.
McGovern McFerry kicking into the wind, fan touch, okay, it's on the 10-metre line. Was the replay of Donald Lawler conceding the penalty. Nice possession from the line out. They go to Keelan, he used him as the go-to man. Turnover ball here, little chip for the corner. Nice idea. Well, very little Keane Kelleher could, or Keane O'Donoghue could do about that. Brave decision not to play the ball, but he made the right call.
Well,
there's the turnover. On.
Lovely little kick, pinning Clongos back in their 22 again. And I think Keane O'Donoghue did the right thing there. If he had got the ball himself, he would have been tackled into touch and would have gone back to St. Michael's possession-wise.
Well, I got this one wrong. I thought Keane O'Donoghue let the ball go. St. Michael's have made another change. Andy Coleman off, Stephen Harrell comes in his place.
Same again, man in front. Man in front.
And blocking in the line out, the ball taken nicely. But St. Michael's concede the penalty.
Man in front.
It's quite clear there, the referee saying man in front. St. Michael's supporters right in front of the referee aren't too happy with that call.
Still a long way downfield into this breeze. That's a good clearance to touch.
Under 22.
McFerry's kicking the ball from hand now.
Yeah, you can see the lifter had got in front to block. It's for the driving ball. Offside.
Brian Byrne throws to the Clongos line. Peel away from the back from Daniel O'Byrne.
Hands off.
Clongos need a little bit more from the three men in the front row. That was a nice release to Fromm. He held onto the ball well. And the whistle blows. The ball went loose. I thought he managed to hold on to it. It was an awkward pass. Didn't go straight into the hands of the first of attempt. It's a scrum for Michaels. The referee not tolerating any delay.
Well, St. Michael's are lying very flat. They're coming up very fast here, and Clongos aren't finding any gaps. I think they need to mix it up a little bit here. I don't think they need possibly kick as deep. I think they can dink it over the top and be pouring through. But Michaels are being very organised, very disciplined in their defence.
Lawler pops the ball up to Holland. Holland gives it to Byrne. Great little break. There's a chance here. Levy, good step. Tackle. Brilliant, brilliant defence from Clongos. But St. Michael's still have it. And the peel away again, just an accidental offside. Dan Levy, the captain.
Well, what a break, what an angle. St. Michael's are cutting Clongos apart there. Just the angle, first of all, is a decoy runner. And McFarland again, he's had put in some big hits today. He's not the biggest player on the park, but certainly he hits as hard as anybody out there.
Touch.
Well, that was a try-saving tackle for sure.
But most importantly, it actually stopped the offload. Levy was hit with such force, he wasn't able to offload the ball because there was plenty of supporters around him. But because he was hit so hard by McFarland, he went to ground, and Clongos were able to regroup.
Well, there's the St. Michael's captain. He's led from the front today, Dan Levy.
Come up, come in a bit closer. Okay, come in. I'm not going to waste time. Just reset quickly.
St. Michael's are playing this game very, very cleverly indeed. They have the lead, they have the wind at their backs, and they're keeping the ball in the Clongos half and in their Clongos 22 whenever they can.
Stay.
Timmins picks from the back, gets away from one tackle out to the 22 almost. Great work from the number eight. Sullivan to McQuaid. Crossfield kick, it sliced a little bit. That could work out okay. Two men jump.
Fine.
Referee says it's okay. Scooped up off the ground.
Tackle and release.
I'm not sure that was the intended tactic, but it's worked out well. Sullivan, it's tight on that narrow side. St. Michael's in again like terriers competing for the ball. You heard the shouts of release from the bench.
Holding on.
I'm sure Paul Haycock was well onto it anyway, Peter.
No.
He was, but I'm sure it didn't hurt to have people shouting it so close to him that the player wasn't releasing it, just bringing his attention to the fact. He's been consistent, the referee, when it came to the breakdown. It's been heavily regulated. Both sides are trying to stop the others offloading.
Well, Killian Burke comes on, number 22, for Clongowes Wood. Here we see the penalty. Great tackle by Ross Byrne. And the next man in for Michaels. He wasn't involved in the tackle. He's entitled to play for the ball.
Yeah, technically, both sides have been very, very good at the breakdown when they've been trying to stop the opposition, the ball going back, getting very good low body positions. Great bravery as well. It's quite easy just not to contest for it. Nobody would think any worse of you, but they are committed. Great attitude by both teams when it comes to the breakdown.
We'll just have to try and keep an eye on how Clongowes line out. Killian Burke played at fullback in the last round.
Holding on.
The referee sends the clock ticking once again. Ross Byrne, oh, he'd only about 3 metres of angle to work with. It's van touch, that's what matters.
Yeah, I think it's McFerry who's actually gone into the half position for Clongowes.
In the fight.
St. Michael's have possession from the line out. Levy, their captain. Held by Keelan as opposite number. Little sniping break by Holland. Andy Barr calling for some support. Donna Lawler is there.
Four, not from the side, four.
Barr gets his shoulders low. He's had a good game, the prop forward.
Hands away!
Oh, are they going to line up for a drop goal here? Little look back from Holland, they go back to Byrne. Just near the 10-metre line, he's cut it nicely. Has he got the direction? It's away to the right-hand side. Well, that's a real threat. He carried that dead ball on by quite a distance.
It was the right thing to do. It was slow ball. They got themselves into a very good position. Keelan and Byrne, Edward up very, very quickly there, looking to put Ross Byrne off, which succeeded. And there's a few players down on the ground now, suffering from cramp. It's been one of those days. It's been such a fast game, ball in hand, and it's taken its toll now.
I think it's Edward is down from the Clongowes, just stretching for his cramp. Michael's player seems to have ankle problems as well. Gets back to his feet. That's Gavin Kelly. Oh, he's okay to go on. As I said, Peter, a match like this, no one wants to leave the field.
Well, especially when you see the players actually on the ground, it's a lot of them are front row players or tight five, and they have been putting themselves around the park. It has just been very impressive, the display by both packs. They've been mobile, athletic. God, in my day, it was, you know, the fours didn't run really. They scrummaged, they lineouts, and that was it. Whereas now, it's, God, it doesn't matter what number is on your back. The players are getting around the park, they're doing the position. Everybody's a back row player, everybody's a back, and everybody at times seems to be a forward.
Well, Ed Byrne is okay.
Time on, Kev.
Trots back.
Stay behind him.
And ready to lead his side. We're into the final 10 minutes. St. Michael's leading by 10 points to 3. McFerry. That's great height on that 22-metre dropout. Well taken. Josh Murphy was tackled. St. Michael's back to halfway. Well, they're playing with more and more confidence now. Brilliant break by Rory Kavanagh. See some open country. Is he going to get stopped this time? McFarlane again puts in the big tackle. Michaels were able to release the ball and recycle quickly there. They edge on 10 metres away from the try line. Good mature play. Didn't panic. They got the ball to Levy. Will they go back to Byrne for another drop goal attempt? Straight in front of the post now. Doesn't look like they're going to go this time. Bobby Holland has the choices. They've had a look at Byrne. They're keeping it to the big man. Ross Byrne is number 10. No sign of him dropping back into the pocket. Is he moving back now? He's straight behind the ruck. Levy and Lawler are waiting. They go to Barr with the support of Levy and Lawler.
Hands off!
Again, it's sensible play. The clock will be in the back of their minds as well. The longer they keep Clongos in the 22, the better chance they'll hold out for the win. And I say hold out, it's being a little bit fair. St. Michael's really in the ascendancy. They're having a look to move the ball now. Well, Ross Byrne is in the line. A little bit of a missed move, Holland. Well marshalled that time by the Clongos defence. And St. Michael's keep their hands on the ball. It's really good stuff. It's really patient play. Well, it's all hands to the pump in there. St. Michael's getting plenty of the backs involved in the rucking to secure possession. Levy this time skips away. Sidestep, can he stretch and reach the line? It's a try! Second try for St. Michael's. What a brilliant piece of play. Patient build-up. And they spotted the gap. And the St. Michael supporters have gone wild once again.
And well, they should. That's a testament to clever, intelligent play. Ross Byrne forewent the chance of going for a drop goal himself. Look at that break by Rory Cavanagh that set it all up. He's fended gaps time and time again today. Held on, secure good Congo scramble defence. Pumping the legs, great speed. Deep into the Congo's 22, and then Michael's just held on, and then Levy. It's a little step again, and then the outstretched arm is the mismatch we talked about. It was wow. Levy against a smaller back. Had to tackle him around the ankles, and Levy was able to stretch out, scored a try. And well worked by St. Michael's, because you're right, John, it was just patient, intelligent play by St. Michael's.
Yes, that's correct.
Ross Byrne will have the conversion attempt. He's on the 15-metre line, 15 in from the touchline, and on the 22. Well, they're racing out for Clongos. The kick is on its way, though. The kick is good. Super kick from Ross Byrne. Well, he seems to be suffering from cramp a little bit as he trots back. Well, he'll just stretch and continue, but it's a 14-point lead now. Here's the try again, Peter.
Well, I'm wondering, are we watching the future Ireland number 7? Not wanting to put any pressure on him, but he's been exceptional today. He has led by example, been a fantastic captain, but also as a number 7, he's been outstanding.
Clongos 3, St. Michael's 17. Clongos were hot favourites coming into this game. But St. Michael's... St. Michael's have put it up to them today. Substitution, Wallace is off. Sean Mulholland is on for Clongos, number 19.
Back you go, it's not out. Make sure you're behind.
Well, can the changes just produce a little bit of magic for Clongos? They've 5 minutes to get two tries. McFarlane under the long clearance downfield.
Hands off!
Clongos now have to dig in. They need to respond quickly and get a score. And then set up a frantic last couple of minutes. Brian Byrne powering his way across the halfway line. Whipped out by O'Sullivan. McVerry, nice little show, but the St. Michael's tackles are unrelenting. Sullivan moves it once again. Great offload from the tackle. Was from able to hold on to the ball. Did really, really well. Now have St. Michael's. Clonger's got a chance here. Timmins, good handoff. Got away from Levy, but the supporting tackle came in. Here come Clongos once again. O'Byrne, did he get the ball away? The touch judge's flag is up.
Touch call.
And Michael's got across. Every tackle is cheered like a score at this stage, Peter.
Well, I'm watching four players down with cramp at the moment. Actually, I think a fifth has just joined them. Big hit, Gavin Kelly. Holland in there as well, and the hit. He's a big lad, Daniel O'Byrne, and that's twice he was involved in that move. Carrying the ball forward. Looking to offload, but because of the tackle that went in low and high, stopped the offload.
Well, let's hear what Matt Williams thinks of this.
Well, it's a classic of defence wins finals, because St. Michael's have just tackled their heart out. They've probably had a smaller percentage of possession over the first half, into the wind in particular, and Clongos just didn't get enough points up in that first half. and then they've really played and taken their opportunities superbly. That last try was brilliantly worked. And what we're seeing is these young guys putting the template of Leinster into play. They're copying what they see every week, their province play. And it's exciting rugby. It's great defence, great attack from both sides. And it's really encouraging for the future of Irish rugby.
Thank you, Matt. We restart line out for St. Michael's. The ball has gone a little bit loose. They've introduced Alex Penny in place of Josh Murphy. Kennedy Clongos. Frantic stuff at the RDS.
But just to build on the point that Matt was making there back in the studio about putting into play what they see Leinster do time and time again, it's their actual ability to be able to do that. They're able to do what professional teams do week in, week out. The same type of complicated moves, procedures, patterns. And it's been unbelievably impressive to watch.
Well, Clongos, no, a three-pointer is no good. They've gone for the corner. Brian Byrne to throw. They have possession from the line-out. St. Michael's didn't contest in the air. And here comes the drive. Clongos' first real chance of attacking that try line. St. Michael's have defended well. They just turned it round slightly. Sullivan almost cracked, still has the ball. Now he's hit hard. And the support comes in. Robert Daly calling in some reinforcements. Every minute important here for St. Michael's. Another drive in the further line. Shout at the referee, whistle blows, penalty. St. Michael's will be happy enough to concede penalties. They don't, it's taken quickly. Referee wants it back. Wasn't clearly tapped in his opinion by Daniel O'Byrne. Not sure if Byrne made it anyway. Or O'Byrne rather. Clongo's called the scrum. I think it's a good tactic, Peter.
I'm a little bit surprised because it was not clearly tapped. Meant it wasn't taken properly, which really should be a scrum, I would have thought, to St. Michael's. But referee deeming that they could retake it. Clever scrum has been dominant. It's about getting quick, solid ball here. And I think for Michael's, it's the defence that they have displayed so far. If they can keep doing that and just wind down that clock, because there's only a minute and a half now for Clongos left to score two tries.
Ball into the scrum. Timmins at the back, fields away. Well tackled. Hardly got moving when he was hit. Sullivan calling the change of direction. St. Michael's make the tackles once again. The ball is there. Referee shouting at Alex Penny to get away from Sullivan. The ball is popped up. Clongo stopped half a metre short from the line. And St. Michael's get the penalty. Or is it a try awarded? I beg your pardon. I thought he gave the try to St. Michael's. Ed Byrne races back. There is a chance for Clongo's. Well, come at the hour, come at the man. Edward Byrne leading from the front. Here we see it from behind the goal.
Good, powerful, surging play. Quick pick and go. Referee not needing to go to TMO at all this afternoon. He's been very decisive in it with his decisions, but for Clongos.
Conor Mahoney has come all the way out to the 22-metre line for this conversion. He's just 2 or 3 metres right of the posts. The ball is behind the post. You can't see it on your screen in that shot. There's the kick. And the kick is good. 15 seconds left in the game. It's 7 points. Clongos need to get the restart and get 60, 70 metres downfield.
It's a big ask, but they're capable of it, and their supporters are rising to the challenge also. Michaels would not be rushing to take this kick at all. They just want that clock to wind down some more, and Clongos need to secure possession from this kickoff.
Well, Ross Byrne is going to kick this a long, long way, you can be sure of that. Well, he gets good height on it, it's coming down at the 22. Clongos have possession. 75 metres or so of RDS grass they need to cover. And they'll want to try and score close to the posts. The referee will allow play go on until there's an infringement of the ball, goes out of play. St. Michael's. Well, they look like they're not tired at all, flying up to make the tackles. Clongos have it again. They can't afford to kick it away. Out of the 22, McFarlane got the pass away nicely. Burke caught in possession. St. Michael's come the narrow side, Byrne the try scorer.
Hands up, four,
he was unable to power his way through that time. Great counter looking by St. Michael's. Sullivan has to reach in. The game goes on when the ball is alive. Now can they move it wide here? They might have a gap. There's a St. Michael's player down. Fromm is into a little bit of space. Attacking the 10-meter line. Gets tackled at halfway. The purple and white shirts are there in support. Sullivan is tackled.
No the hands,
reaches back. Shows the ball. Clongers without a scrum half though. What a break by Fromm. But there's still 50 metres to go. They're all catching their breath. Killian Birch standing over the ball. Clongers just shoved forward. Is Sullivan able to get back to his feet? Clongers spin the ball once again. Byrne, the captain, gets away from Ross Byrne. Great release of the ball. McFarland unable to get outside. Tackled by his opposite number, Diamond. Popped up to Fromm. Unbelievable stuff. Penalty to Clongers. There won't be time to go for touch. Sullivan taps it. Goes to his captain, Byrne. Ed Byrne bounces off one tackle. Up to the 22-metre line. Is there a try in this Clongers side? Will they get the conversion if they get the try? Great step by Burke. Well, what energy's left in the St. Michael's side. On they go, Daniel O'Byrne into the 22. Brilliant, brilliant play. This is absolutely superb stuff from Clongers. They move the ball once again. Paul racing at the defensive line. Stopped in his tracks. And St. Michael's need to keep making the tackles here. That one was a little bit awkward. Clongers somehow hold on to possession. Sullivan moves it once again. Fromm is on his shoulder. Couldn't get the pass away. Double tackled. Sullivan moves it once again. Keelan got the pass to Byrne. Ross Byrne made the tackle. Sullivan has to get it away. Pops it up. Timmins just lost his footing. Ed Byrne in to protect the ball. Well, there's... How are they managing to keep going? It's unbelievable stuff here. Sullivan moves it one more time. Daniel O'Byrne. 15 players on each side. They must be out on their feet. They come to the narrow side. Burke, he's got magic feet. Couldn't use it that time. Sullivan into the 22. Almost 4 minutes past the 70. Sullivan moves it infield. McVerry realised the passing option wasn't on, took the tackle. Now there's options both sides for Clongers. Ed Byrne, the go-to man once again, but tackled low. They've taken him around the ankles. The whistle blows. Penalty to St. Michael's. That will bring the final whistle, surely.
Well, that was bravery and its very essence by Clongers, but also by St. Michael's in defence. Clongers. And 60, 70 metres there. How many phases we went through?
Well, Paul Haycock asked St. Michael's to kick the ball to touch. Ross Byrne did that. It's been a fantastic game at the RDS. St. Michael's the champions. They win. Clongers 10, St. Michael's College 17.
Unbelievable few minutes. I didn't think, we thought we'd be here at 8 o'clock tonight. Fantastic game. Analysis and the trophy after the break. Stay with us. Let's move to Kevin Leahy.
With me is the coach of St. Michael's, Kelvin Leahy. Kelvin, you're looking very relaxed. I can hardly speak. That was a fantastic win.
I'm delighted. I'm delighted for the school. I'm delighted for the St. Michael's community. And I'm delighted above all for the boys. This is a day they'll remember for the rest of their lives. And it's thoroughly deserved, I thought.
Well, in a couple of hard luck stories against Clongers in the last couple of years, it was great to get the win today.
Yeah, sometimes you have to lose one to win one. And often we've been labelled the Nearly boys. But today we were determined to set that record straight, and I think the lads did that.
Well, you deserve great credit. We're joined here by the captain. Daniel, how are you feeling? Fantastic win, well done.
Absolutely speechless after that. Credit to Clongowes and all the other teams, Prez, Ross, Grant, Kilkenny as well. They're all unbelievable in this competition, and absolutely breathless after that. Absolutely, lost for words. Incredible.
Well, congratulations. All 15 and the subs, you put yourselves around, you tackled really, really hard.
Yeah, we knew we'd have to get off the line against Clongowes. You know, they're big boys, very physical, and we did it today. They even showed in the last 5 minutes the dedication and the skill even to get around us in the last and get a try at the end and really put us under pressure. So,
where did you all get the energy from in the last 5 minutes? Your tackling was incredible right to the end.
I have absolutely no idea. I was just spurred on by the subs, obviously, and then the crowd and everything was incredible.
Well, Dan, congratulations. You go ahead and get the cup. Really well done.
Thanks a lot. Thank you.
Well, you can see why St Michael's are so well guided. Kelvin there with wonderful words before and after the game, and well done to the young captain there, Dan. First thing you do is congratulate the opposition, and more credit to him for that. Freno, a really good game of rugby.
Yeah, the speed and the power and the football intelligence of these kids, you'd have to say, and I mean, both coaches, the type of brand of rugby they wanted to play was exceptional, and that final burnout in the last 5 minutes.
It's amazing.
But I, to be honest, I think the best team won it. I don't think Clongowes were used to being treated like that throughout the whole season, and they met a side there that knew that they were capable of winning this side, and defensively they played it was a masterclass in defence. Very, very well organised. Structurally, even in the scramble, they were very, very good, very composed when Clongowes presented a threat to them. I think the win played a big part in this final. And Michael's.
You can see how windy it is there, Fran. Look at the
power. I mean, there's no question. They couldn't kick the ball. They just couldn't kick the ball, and they were forced to run it. You know, we weren't there to see it. Lovely, lovely sunny day, but very strong breeze, and it played a huge part in the game.
You're dead right, Neil. I thought the defence from St Michael's was superb, but you have to say that last few minutes with Clongowes' attack, it was, as Peter McKenna said, for these guys to put into place the systems that we saw today is a huge step forward for the schools in the last 7 or 8 years here in Leinster.
Well, it's a sign of true champions. They never gave up. I'd say there must have been about 25 phases in that final play. And I wouldn't be too sorry. I mean, a lot of that team have a couple of medals already, particularly the Burns there. So I think the better team of the day won.
Well, they're the mum kissing her boys, and it's a tough gig for the kids there. But part of the deal is you've got to cop losing. You've got to cop it on the chin, and you've got to learn to deal with victory and disaster. A lot of people wipe the kids out of losing and protect them. It's not life, is it, mate? You've got to do it as we're getting ready for the presentation of the trophy here.
Well,
to the St Michael's boys. We just got John out on the ground. We'll cross there.
They looked absolutely fantastic through the earlier rounds. St Michael's came through looking equally impressive. And when they were asked the big questions today, St Michael stood up. Edward Byrne, captain of Clongowes Wood. What a performance from him today. Goes over and shakes hands with his opposite captain, Dan Levy. Well, two sets of players, they gave their all, they left nothing behind. St Michael's out to a 14-point lead. Clongowes battle back without a late try. Listen to the cheers around the RDS from the St Michael's supporters. They've all stayed behind to see this momentous occasion. St Michael's College win the Senior Cup for the second time. They won it in 2007. The players line up. Cameron Diamond and Chris Fagan. Rory O'Loughlin, Rory Kavanagh. Ian Kelleher goes forward. Ross Vernon, Bobby Holland, all of the heroes. 21 is Mark O'Keefe. Andy Barr, what a game he had for St Michael's today. There's Bobby Holland, the scrum half. Donna Lawler, their number eight. Jamie Lawless was replaced, but he had a huge game in the first 50 minutes. Gavin Kelly was their scrum half. And look at the smiles from St. Michael's. They lost in the semi-final to Clongowes last year. They lost in the final to Clongowes Wood in 2010. Few players, that shows what a big side they are. The last few players struggling to find their way onto the podium. Daniel Levy's mom, what a proud moment for her. Well, I've spoken to Dan Levy on a couple of occasions this year. He's a very, very unassuming young man. He's about to lift the Leinster Schools Senior Cup. St. Michael's College are the Leinster Schools Senior Cup champions 2012. And look at them celebrate, and well, they deserve it. It was a fantastic performance by them today.
Well, fantastic scenes. I know Keith Gleeson back in Sydney would be pretty happy. Keith's an old boy of St. Michael's, but a few years here before his family came out to Sydney. Richly deserved. Frano, really quickly, we're short of time. The game's in good hands when we're seeing the skills and the attitudes that we saw out there today.
Yeah, I think one or two internationals, particularly that young man in the picture, an outstanding performance. We don't give man of the matches, but if I was to, he was just his contribution to his team's success was just phenomenal. And very good in the back row. I think Lawler as well was very good in the back row. Their midfield did very well. And overall, as a strategically, they did exactly what they do in the second half, keep the ball in the Clongowes half of the field, and they just tackled really, really well, very well organised. And a huge amount of credit also to Kelvin Leahy, the most composed time I've ever seen Kelvin. I've played with him for Leinster, and very composed and assured and intelligent, and a great blueprint he put out to beat a very, very strong Clongowes side.
Well, finals are usually lost, not won. And you've got to say that the team that makes the least mistakes in these games wins. And St. Michael's made less mistakes, tackled their heart out, and then took their opportunities. It has been a great coverage, been great bringing you the full season of Leinster Schools Rugby here on Satanta. Stay with us next year. We'll bring it to you again. It'll be just as exciting, just as much fun, and you'll still see those stars of the future.